System survey complete. Special project complete. The tradition screen displays the tradition trees available to our empire. A tradition tree must first be adopted before any traditions within it can be unlocked. Screen, we can buy and sell resources. At first, this is merely an inventory analyzed. Debris analyzed. An alien empire has established communications. Have made first contact with an alien empire. These fascinating beings appear to have mastered spaceflight, just as we have. We should strive to learn more about them. In the expansion planner, we find nearby habitable planets that may present opportunities for colonization. We can build colony ships and issue them orders directly from this screen. Construction complete. The diplomacy screen is where we communicate. Research complete. System survey complete. Anomaly found. Construction complete. situation log updated. Construction complete. Evading hostile fleet. System survey complete. Special project complete. Research complete. Research complete. System survey complete. Thank you. System survey complete. Blessings upon you, Your Holiness. I am Veer, a prototype synthetic intelligence. The priesthood has ordained me to act as your faithful servant and advisor, so that I may aid you on our divine path to the stars. Very well, I will provide... This is our system's starbase. These upgradable stations mark stars... Military fleets are used. This is our construction ship. This is our science ship, which is used to survey astronomical objects such as planets in a star system. A planet needs to be surveyed in order... This is our homeworld, and the capital of our empire. The planet summary screen, which we are currently looking at, provides an overview of the planet's important statistics and allows us to set a designation if desired. Here we see a breakdown of this planet's population, divided into layers or strata. Construction complete. The technology screen is where we will be... Situation log updated. Construction complete. System survey complete. The Leaders tab lets us hire, dismiss, and assign idle governors, scientists, admirals, and generals. Anomaly found. One of our science ships has just surveyed a world that would make an excellent candidate for our first colony. It is of the same planet class as our home world, so our colonists should be quite comfortable there. The tradition screen displays the tradition trees available to our empire. A tradition tree must first be adopted before any traditions within it can be unlocked. Evading hostile fleet. Situation log updated. Situation log updated. The situation log displays a list of all currently available special projects, archaeology sites, and various other points of interest. New items will likely appear as we begin exploring the galaxy. Anomaly found. Special project complete. In the context. Construction complete. System survey complete. System survey complete. Evading hostile fleet. Science ship under attack. Construction complete. System survey complete. In the Fleet Manager, we can create templates for our military fleets. As our fleets grow in size, These templates make it easier to quickly order replacements for any losses they may have sustained. Anomaly found. Construction complete. The government screen presents us with information. Anomaly found. Construction complete. Construction complete. System survey complete. Situation log updated. Anomaly found. Construction complete. Anomaly found. System survey complete. Construction complete. System survey complete. I have important information for you. Construction complete. Evading hostile fleet. Evading hostile fleet. Anomaly found. Construction complete. System survey complete. Hostile fleet engaged. Construction complete. Evading hostile fleet. Anomaly found. Here, empire-wide edicts, practices. The Policies tab covers government policies, which have wide-ranging effects on how our empire is run. Research complete. Construction complete. System survey complete. Construction complete. Construction complete. Anomaly found. Research complete. Construction complete. Hostile fleet engaged. System survey complete. As our empire grows, trade between our planets will become an increasingly large part of our economy. Starbases with trade hubs collect trade value within their system to be routed to the capital for conversion to energy credits. Construction complete. Construction complete. Thank you. system survey complete. Research complete. Situation log updated.
Apologies, my mic was completely muted. I've been talking to it though for ages. I'm doing pretty well. Slow day. Still just coding stuff up in JavaScript, which is, you know, it's that you can see what you want to get done and you can kind of half see how you're going to do it, but actually turning it into what you need is just a lot of effort, really. And just lazily exploring Stellaris. I haven't really... This game's never really thrilled me. I've tried it a few times, and I know a few people who love it. And I trust their taste, and I really like some of the other Paradox Ground strategies, but I don't know, I never got far enough in a game of Stellaris for stuff to really start happening. But at the same time it feels like it takes quite a long time. Like, I actually just quit a game that I was quite a few hours into because I'd finally made contact with other aliens and they were like here and here, distance. And it just seemed like nothing interesting is going to happen for a while yet. So I restarted, I put the density of other races way up. So
construction complete.
Hopefully, basically, there's a lot less distance I can go without running into anyone. And I'm just bit by bit expanding, basically. My military is almost gone. But I don't want to reinforce, it's too expensive. I do love seeing the really carefully thought through manifestation of a galaxy full of interesting stars. Interesting. A major colony or the homeworld of the species described as non-compliant in League records. So there's an old species called the League of something? And they are, I don't know, hope you're slightly skipping the tooltips. Trade war, orbital debris, blockades violently challenged, fine.
Situation log updated.
Can I now colonize it? Yes, yes, fine. Okay, we've got some factions. I quite like the idea of factions. I haven't found them that interesting yet.
Be aware that shifts in the socio-political climate.
Cool. You want... You don't like robotic life? I feel like I'm fine with not liking robotic life. And you want me to communicate with other species. So I'm actually pretty willing to change my policy on whether or not... Is that what they want for... Oh, what game is that? I've played a few space-based 4X games. But honestly, I find it hard to stay grounded in them. Like, they're... When you're playing something like a strategy game... when you're playing like a Earth-based strategy game like Civ, everything feels relatively logical. You're just like, oh yeah, I need to build farms because the people need farms. But with these... There's a kind of disconnect. Like, I'm not really sure what... In fact, kind of any strategy game in the future... I'm not really sure how important these things are. It's not like knowing that I should research the wheel. I don't have any of this historical context. I don't have that 20/20 hindsight. And that really helps with game literacy.
Construction complete.
I watched a video today I posted about it on Twitter, so it should be findable. I think my Twitter's on Twitch stream. A guy whose wife wanted to try the game Hollow Knight, which, interestingly, my partner had a really similar reaction. It was one game where she was like, I want to play that. She just saw me playing it and she was like, that looks like a game I really want to play. And so he set up playing this and quickly found that it was fascinating. And I found this the same, like without too much sort of studying my partner playing games. It is kind of fascinating to study my partner playing games and see how she learns them and works them out. Given that she hasn't spent a lifetime playing them and thinking about them. You can go survey that. And the crucial thing kind of is... Oh, don't do that. Oh, fine. Is how intuitive. Great. How easily understandable all of the mechanics are. And there's all these things that we learn that are not at all obvious. A whole bunch of video game logic that. Let's have a bunch of population growth speed. Bunch of video game logic that is not at all logical. And we kind of know this. This isn't that surprising. But more than it just not being logical, it can actively shame people trying to work it out. And I like to think about this a lot, not so much in the context of games, but in the context of education and mathematics. It's that shaming factor that... You're doing it wrong if you're doing it wrong. Idea. That I think is so disastrous for young people actually getting to enjoy and experience the joy of maths.
Research complete.
What does it say? I mean, it probably didn't help that turn-based strategy games aren't my favourite form of strategy. Fair enough. This isn't actually turn-based. This is continuous ticking clock, which sort of isn't my favourite kind of strategy. I quite like turn-based because something I often say about ticking clock strategy is you're always on the hook. You always, always can be optimising.
Construction complete.
Give me one of them trade ups. Also, it's just hard to tell with these ticking clock ones kind of what pace you should be going at, because I could be. The amount of detail in this, I could be looking at my fleet and wondering about the traits of my leaders and the exact loadout of my ships and whether or not I can more efficiently use up the power in them and things like that. And it just... it's kind of overwhelming. It's partly there so that the individual has the option to choose how much to interact with it, but it can't avoid also just being being unclear if you're actually playing how it was intended.
Construction complete.
I loved Company of Heroes. It was so hard, though. Like, I never got through the campaign. It was just a slog. Interesting. Found some aliens. They're unfriendly aliens. But I agree, I really like, I love the Total War games. For that more solid feeling battle. Like, I build troops, I send them to hit people. It all makes sense. I feel kind of in control of it. Here, a space battle's going on, and I'm like, well, I don't really feel like I have much control of this, but also I know that I am on the hook for it. Oops. Go survey there. Basically, I keep trying to like this game, and I still haven't really managed to. So I might switch and play something else. Might play some Hearthstone. Ooh, interesting. Neutral aliens. Let's investigate them, neutral aliens. Interesting, let me look it up. I tried Wargame European Escalation a while back, and it was kind of too in-depth for me. I really like making like high-level macroscopic decisions as much as possible. Aha, there are aliens up there. So let's forward settle them. Always forward settle. I got really interested in the game called Distant Worlds Universe a while back, and I played it for a bit. It was really buggy. It was a real passion project game. But the reason that I was really interested in it is it's a game where you can pass over basically everything you're doing in the game to an AI. So you can really choose which bits of the game you're actually having to play, and therefore you need to do a lot less micromanagement. Like, it can run your entire economy, or it can be kind of be your military advisor. And station under attack. I don't feel like it. Oh, hello. The big cross blades, not a great sign. Everything's gone a bit wrong. Powerful pirates are attacking my space station that can't defend itself. And, wow. And I'm now friends. Well, no, not friends. I now can talk to an alien. Contacts. Oh, they like me fine. Kind of multi-mole people.
The diplomacy screen is where we communicate with other civilizations. Here we can declare war, form alliances, and implement trade deals with our neighbors, amongst other things.
Let's be nice to them and guarantee their independence. He told me about For the King, and it looked pretty good, actually. No shirt I've been seeing somewhere. Nice graphical style. I'm just looking at For the King on Steam. Hex-based, love a bit of hex. and Notia. Am I spelling that right? Oh, Noita. You're liking your roguelikes. Oh, again, great graphics. Lovely, kind of deep, many pixels. Am I even breaking through their shields at all? Not really. Where is my fleet is here. I don't think they'll help much. Can I and am I trading with these guys? No, but I would like to be. Don't break all my stuff. Oh wait, I'm not getting any of my trade. Oh, because it's all going through this place. Where?
Mining station lost.
Where the piracy is basically 100%. Why did I not go over here? Oh, because there was enemies here before.
Construction complete.
I don't remember. Oh, they're pretty strong.
Research complete.
That's pretty useful.
Anomaly found.
All right. Oh, interesting. These guys are uplifting another civilization. Stuff like that I think is really cool and I want to play about with. Cool. Just upgrade all of these.
Ships upgraded.
Still not very powerful.
Anomaly found.
So even though there's not much going on in this system, I probably should colonize it just so I can protect from pirates better.
System survey complete.
Not particularly interested in joining my federation. They don't want to communicate with me. If we give them some minerals and then they think we're really cool. Nope, don't want to give us any of those. They don't really seem to actually want to trade anything with us. Nothing can be done. Let's go see how badly I lose this battle against the pirates. And then, yeah, I think I might change to Hearthstone for a bit. Okay, so also they've decided they're our rivals. So this is a much more interesting game than the one before, in that it's going terribly. Let's watch my fleet get blown up and then call it a day. I think this might be interesting to come back to, because it's much more down on my luck. How's the battle going? Really, just not well. I might take out one of their ships. Oh yeah. That's a treat. Okay. I don't even need to save it, because it saves automatically. Yeah, let's jump into Hearthstone. I have a feeling it might not be fully set up on here, but let's find out. Because I can't remember the last time I played it on this computer. I've been playing loads on my phone recently. Which is kind of great. It's a really nice scale of game to be playing on your phone. Streaming whilst trying to update, download a big update might be a bad idea. What else is updating? Oh. That might be a bust. Oh, I can't even jump into that. Everything updating at the worst time. Now that's quick at least. I've been thinking, talking about RTSs, I've been thinking for a while that I should actually try out StarCraft, which I played years ago with an old friend. He used to play StarCraft 1, Oh, that's pretty quick. But apparently it's got a great single-player campaign. Which is really what I'm most interested in it for. I don't think I'm about to get into the competitive online scene. Are you a big fan? While I'm waiting, I'm going to see if anyone's answered my Stack Exchange question. Nope. Would you play competitively or cooperatively? I feel like I miss beefy cooperative games. Like ones that you could really get into. As a team rather than against each other. Does that not get boring, playing the same person over and over again? I've never tried it, so it really might not. It just seems like you kind of have each other sussed out. Yeah, fair enough. I guess there's a lot to learn. Still trying to decide if I'm I mean, I think that's lovely, the really going through, rolling through a whole series of tactics, kind of Red Queen chess, learning just fast enough to stay ahead of the other one as they do the same. Fifty-fifty, because Hearthstone does this sometimes. It'll open up and immediately say, I have to update something.
Hold on to your mug. We're in for a wild night.
Fine. And that's quite nice. So this price going up has made one of the decks I use way worse. Has that gone up from 3? Fine with me. Let's just jump into playing some normal matches. Especially given that I've got a Warlock quest to complete. So I don't know when the last time you played this was, but they added something that I really like, which is... That is not my deck. My deck. I think it's that. Yeah, that's right. I don't really want any of these. Circle can be good, but only when I've got the right stuff. So there's four decks, which it gives you all the cards for, which is great, because actually getting a full deck with like legendaries and everything with the cards is just an uphill struggle. So it gives you all the cards for it, and then you can't edit any of them, but it's pretty much a competitive deck. This one is definitely the one that I feel least like I've got the measure of. Yeah, exactly. Whiz bang on the cloak. This is the cloak. I could silence this. I think I might leave it for next turn. I'm not too convinced by this silence. Like, deck archetype. Also, these decks have no cards from the newest expansion, and the newest expansion is pretty good. As they kind of always are. Like, this deck I'm playing against, it just kind of goes crazy once it's got the double back cries. So my main option here is just really speeding through. Because doubling up this guy, it's pretty strong. Mm-hmm. That's fun. Doubling up this guy is even more strong. It's tempting to do that. No, let's go for... I'm an idiot. Oh, long day. Okay, let's do this. I'm going to pretend that this is what I meant to do. Let's see what we get from that. Given that they're likely to put a lot down, let's take this. And I'll keep healing my my unusable card. So that will be 3 mana by the time that comes out. I could do better than that. I don't want this sticking around though. I don't know if there's any cards left that reward you for how many times you've used your hero power, but... for a while that was the case. So it's always better to just self-hero power. This has in no way been a strong enough start. And I basically fully expect to lose this. So it's nice that it's no longer free, but it can be. I Let's do this. Yeah, all right, that'd be great. I'd be up for that. Just start pushing damage. Oh, I bet it's going to be all right. Question is, are you going to have stream up whilst we're playing? Because that's going to be completely unfair, but I'm not completely opposed to it. So this is when this deck starts to be doing good stuff. Fair enough. So, as long as I don't tell you what's in my hand, which I may well do. Because I do love complaining about getting the wrong cards. Strong. This rush down technique. Full 7/7 and go face. Wait, is that your plan? Or is that what I should be doing? Oh, yeah. Long gone, the 4-mana 7/7, though. We have to work out if any reborn minions are particularly strong. I think the there's a warrior one with rush, which is pretty strong. Now that isn't great for my plan. My plan already wasn't great. If I get a Nilshire cleric, I just about might have a chance. It's interesting. I wonder what this person's feeling on the other side of this. Like, I feel like I don't really have a hope in hell, and they're doing pretty strong. But they might be sitting here thinking the same thing. I got nothing. It's just stupidly go face. I got nothing apart from I do have enough damage on the board to be lethal. Like, it's that weird, false threat. This person really just needs to survive a couple more turns and I'll have completely run out of gas. Now, I'm actually okay with that sticking around. Because I'd rather that than the 2/2s. That's less good. Now this is surprisingly strong. It's kind of just extending the game. Also, he has a shadow walk in his deck. Eventually it'll all go wrong. Not really any way around that. Yeah, I'm just gonna concede this. Did you add me? Did you get Hearthstone up? No sign of it. Fair enough. Hearthstone's definitely one of those games which I'm more fascinated in as a kind of mathematical exercise than specifically. No, that's the wrong deck. Than specifically as a for the playing of it. I feel like I'm not very good at playing it. After what must be hundreds of hours. Although, I also feel like people I'm playing against might well be thousands of hours into it. Not a fan of Bomb Warrior? I always like it. I think it's got a lot of decision points. I think it's a really interesting way of doing damage to someone, putting bombs in their deck. It's really not strong, but I'm actually going to coin this turn. And the reason I'm going to do that is just to get one more card out of the deck and increase my chance of drawing an Elec. Because if I can get an Elec and then shuffle a ton of bombs in, which is quite conditional, but if it can be done, then when the Blastmaster Boom comes down, it's really strong. And I'll have this big tempo advantage. I'll kind of be able to play the game at my own pace. No such luck. Now, he doesn't have any hugely great way to deal with this. It's kind of a waste for him. Of one of those rushes. I'm actually a big fan of taking. That's not what I want to see. Of actually trying to take damage in the early game, just so an inevitable Ziliax does some healing. She asks possible he has weapons project, which would be annoying. Would that have been an option if he had, if I'd hit him? Yeah, it would. Still would have been able to do that. That's rather nice, although I don't need it yet. God, I can't catch a break on these bombs. Guess it's stopping him shield slamming again, although shield slamming that last time was not very strong. I think I'm getting four from this. Hope I'm getting full. Yeah. Oh, pretty good timing. There's no really great way around this. Is there any advantage to not using Dr. Boom for it? It'd be nice to hit him in the face. But equally, I'm losing all this damage going face. Let's just threaten from like every direction at once. Now, I know this person has a bunch of big taunt minions and probably some warpaths, so there's plenty of ways. Blow up in my face. But it's just a lot of pressure. So if he spends his turn warpathing me, I can justify spending my turn playing Dr. Boom Mad Genius. That going up to 9 mana, not just to 8 mana, is really annoying. Like having that extra mana on turn 10, it's just a hassle. Feels bad. Yeah, it was a bit too much. Five wouldn't be enough. Oh, 7 is. That's cool. No! Oh my god, I'm an idiot. I'm so dumb sometimes. I don't deserve to win this game anymore. Still might, but I don't deserve to. Yep, that wouldn't have been possible. Times like this, I wish I ran a silence. Not that I chose these cards, but... let's see what we get. That's pretty much the perfect thing, so let's play that. Also, these come out immune because of that guy. So I can work my way through all of them. And depending on what he plays, this could come out very strong. Particularly because I can give it the +2. So he hasn't played an Armegadillo, which would be buffing up his taunts. So, two Mordens would come out as defeatable. Probably the worst one. But it leaves pretty interesting possibilities with, depending on what I draw. Not a very interesting draw. No point in buffing that yet. God, that was a huge life difference. Leaving up the nullifier. Also, I'm just realizing it had untargetable. Shame. I'm okay with taking the 12 damage to face, am I? Yeah, exactly, but he would have been much more, like, proportionally feeling secure in surviving it. Yeah, I'm okay with taking the 12. Can even... I regret nothing. That was the wrong thing to do. Yeah, gross. I'm wondering how much damage have I passed over to him in this game? If I hit both of these, they'll be on 2 and 3. So this doesn't really do anything. Or I can play the Batterhead. I mean, this is a good target for the Super Collider. Is there going to be any better target for this? No, I'm doing this. I think he's probably, by my series of misplays, pulled this one out of the bag. Now that's rather nice. Let's see if it manages to survive. I love a snowballing threat. They're not actually very strong, but... I think it does just put fear in people's hearts. I thought my deck tracker kept track of how many bombs were in the deck. Oh, that would have been good last turn. Leaving that on 4 is not a good idea. Ideally, I want to attack this into that. If I do that, that'll lose 2, be on 5. Not really any use to me at all. Not perfect. Oh, that's hopeful. One more. You say it's astonishing. I have put quite a lot of bombs into your deck, my friend. It's all part of the plan. He does have now to fear. Oh no, not with Armor Up, obviously. To every turn, just fear instant, uncalled for death. I'm going to do my best to keep him on one bomb draw from death. So I think he's used both his warpaths. Yeah. Great art on this. That's pretty nice. Yep. Happy with that. And the question is, do I leave this up? Yeah, it's better than doing the damage one by one. Otherwise, he'd gain 6 armor from it. So, he must have some taunt minion in his hand to have played that. I think it's quite likely going to be a Tomb Warden. Apparently, we win. All I like to do is keep it more fair by. Playing really badly. Alright, do you want to add me? Recruit friends? I've not pressed this button before. good name. Are we playing standard? Wild? Let's just check what the tempo is at the moment. Oh, it's still the zombies one. It's not that interesting. I think I press standard. I hovered my mouse over both. So this shows how I play quite a bit of online games, but almost entirely ones where I don't play with other people, basically. I've not played a game of Hearthstone against another person before, as ludicrous as that sounds. Interesting. It's a mirror match, but I'm guessing we're not the same same deck. This is actually one of my favourite decks in the set of evil decks. Some could have argued that I probably should have done that last turn, but just keeping it fresh. The old nine cards and nothing to do. I'm never really sure if I should be playing more for tempo or more for board. More for, like, hitting in the face or more for board. I think I overtrade. This is why I love this deck. Those are kind of the most boring of all of those options, but really not thinking very hard. There was no reason to pop that. Efficient tool use. It's kind of my instinct to always play this on an empty board, but actually, if there's something worth defending, it's not bad in this form. Do you have a mortal coil to follow it up, or is that just... Fascinating. I don't really know the deck archetypes that well, but this is not a card I expected to see. And it makes me think that you might be on your way to doing some, some combo that I'd rather not be on the receiving end of. Said it's got to be pretty good and pretty immediate. Hey dog. How you doing? Do you want to go out in the garden soon? Probably just a couple more games. Alright, now we get the fun. Okay. What? Oh yeah, obviously. Doesn't matter, they all die. But I come back at full health. Gotta say, it's not looking great for you, but again, there's always the possibility. Play again? That deck particularly, it just has the most fantastic weird turns happen. Like, I don't think it's actually very reliable or particularly strong, but the Dull Master... Oh, you're playing against Bone Warrior. The Dull Master, the Rush guy, and also then the farm to like finish it up. Like, if it gets through to the late game, you might not necessarily win, but a bunch is going to happen and it's going to be interesting. Now, if you're going to keep playing the same deck, I can actually get to know what's in it. Which is something I've never really had. Probably could have had more deads, but... Your favourite. Oh, different deck. Cool.
I could have drawn better there.
So I definitely get the feeling that this board for the small things is not going to stay small. He's really good, but this guy's kind of my favourite. I just love the promise that that he might keep growing forever. You're really attached to that flame imp. I'm just going to slow you down a bit. What spell could you find that would really mess me up? Your spell discovery is within your class, isn't it? Do you know what happens when this guy pops, right? Oh man, weapon removal is no fun. Okay, I tire of your flame imp. I don't actually think this card is too overpowered, but a situation like that makes it seem like it is crazy powerful. And particularly if it gets buffed by something. Like, if you get an Omega Dillo onto it. Or, there's that card in my deck which... which buffs a Rush minion. if it overkills something. How I wish this had one more health. There was probably some interesting reason why it was better to go for that one. Maybe. See, this is always a terrifying moment, because whilst I feel like this is probably good news for me, anything could come out of this. I'm not brimming with health. I think I've got time. Kind of amazing to me that, like, I know you couldn't play it with this class, but that Archivist Elysiana is kind of just unconditionally more powerful than Academic Espionage. I'm sitting on a plan and I'm trying to work out if it's really stupid or quite good. No, it's really stupid. So here's something I've always wondered. I presume we're both playing on the same board. Well, that's absolutely terrifying. But I don't know that for certain. Are you playing on the Cashin's Rumble board? Gotta love hitting an 8-8 in the face. And you thought getting all the bombs out of your deck was going to be a good idea. Wow. Okay. That is quite large. And my plan against it is very basic. I think you got a 1 and 2. Ooh. I think there's 4 bombs in your deck. What a weird card. Start your turn, shuffle this minion into your deck. I guess it means that you can continuously, Oh, I don't want to attack it, though. It is worth attacking it, isn't it? Nothing I do can make any difference, so may as well do this. Oh, man! Oh, well played. Okay, one more. And then I think I'm going to call it a night. Yeah. Do you know how many bombs are in your deck? I have a feeling that they might have been majority by that point. I would argue maybe worth killing the Elec just to reduce the number of bombs coming in by 1. I love, though, the high roll of playing the attack and health doubling one onto huge minions. I think you must be back on Azale's deck. Is it Azale? The cloak. Yeah. Oh, really? Cool. Interesting choice. All right. Let's get scary about it. Sort of whatever happens with this priest deck, I always find it a bit unsatisfying. Just because you either win the game or lose the game within the first little while. That's not ideal. Also, it sucks to just be stuck with a handful of minions that don't actually do anything. Here we go. Pretty good. I've never actually had that happen before, but now I think about it, that's a really cool combination. Also, could you have had a better set of results than that? I'm not sure you could. I have absolutely lost this game. I have one possible out. Okay. Am I dead? No, I'm not dead to board. I can't resist this. It's not a good idea, but so I know you've got the rush guy. None of these were what I wanted.
This will probably go well for me.
I'm intrigued by including the Undertaker. I guess you have almost certainly some powerful death rattles have happened. Oh, that's pretty horrible. That is not good. Nope, I am out. That's useless, that's useless, and that's useless. So, who's the real winner here? Oh well. That was a lot of fun, man. Thanks for playing. We should do this again sometime. But for the moment, I'm gonna go make myself some dinner. That makes sense. See you around.